Students frequently have problems understanding the concept of quality of protein, so this video is to help you visualize what this means. We have, as we know, when we eat foods, our foods are going to digest, we're going to eat it, and we're going to unfold it in the stomach, and we'll end up with those end products of digestion in the small intestines to the single amino acids. And then these amino acids will be absorbed and put into that amino acid pool. Absorption. So I want to remind you that there is no specific place in the body that has an amino acid pool. It's just a way to visualize and to think about these single amino acids, and that the body will use these amino acids to actually pull from to produce a protein. So we're going to pull from that, whether it's from a blood or from a cell itself. We'll pull from this pool of amino acids to create a body protein. And so this is going to be our goal protein. And with this example, I've been using letters to represent amino acids. And though we know that the sequence of amino acids is going to be important, we've got to have the sequence determined by the DNA to give us our structure of protein that we need eventually. And with this example, I'm using some color coding here. If the letter is gray, we're going to say that it's a non-essential amino acid. If the a letter has a color to it, we'll just say that that's an essential amino acid. And how that makes a difference when it comes to what happens when you don't have enough of one or the other. So if we're going to build this sequence of amino acids, we have to come from a pool. And we can see that we have C, so we'll just make a mark. But we have one G. We'll make a mark by that G and say, yeah, we've got that. We've got plenty of E's. So we're going to mark our E's. We've got S's. We only had the one G, so we now have a problem. We do not have a G. We have plenty of T's, and we're going to see we've got the rest of these are doing fine. We have a C. We don't have a P. So if we look at our pool of amino acids, there's not a P, but we do have plenty of S's, and again, we know that we've run out of our G's. So now we have a situation where we don't have all the amino acids there to produce our protein. You must have all the amino acids before you can produce a protein. If it's a non-essential amino acid, it's no problem. We can convert, if a non-essential amino acid is missing, we'll just convert. Convert one non-essential amino acid to another. And so we could just take an extra T, for an example, and we'll convert that to a P. So there will be no problem. We can continue to produce our protein because we can actually get our P from another non-essential amino acid. But let's take a look at what happens if there isn't enough essential amino acids. We know here that there's inadequate, in this example, there's inadequate G's. And with that G, it's an essential amino acid. We cannot produce it. By definition, essential means we must eat it. In this instance, we will actually stop protein production. And that can lead to problems. It can lead to lack of health. We can't produce our immune antibodies. We can't produce growth because we can't grow enough. So that amount of essential amino acids in the original food, we come back to the original food and we have to look at the types of amino acids that are in there, because that is going to be what gives us the pool of amino acids to pull from to make our protein. So we can come back to, how do we measure the quality of the protein? Protein quality is a measure of how well the protein in food provides those essential amino acids to meet protein production. And if we don't have enough essential amino acids, our protein production will be limited or stopped. So non-essential amino acid, no problem, but essential amino acid, we will have health problems or just won't be able to produce enough of the protein to maintain body structure.